guys, this is Wiley Dave, friends with Cryptid Brothers Investigations of Oklahoma. I'm over here by Skytook Lake today to talk to a young man that's 9 years old that's seen a Sasquatch back in about August. And we've been trying to get over here to talk to him. There's something in the woods in Oklahoma. People have been seeing these things since back in the 1800s. Some believe it, some don't. Hunters see them, and some of them say things. Some of them won't go back in the woods. I know some guys personally that have sold their guns and bows, and they give up hunting. They won't go back in the woods. But we're on our team, and we're here to find out what this is. Lance and Bill and Lane, they're down at the Honabi Festival. And this fell to me and Mike, because this is really our territory here. So we come over here by the lake to talk to this young man. Now this sign behind me is 9 foot tall. And what he tells me is when he seen this run off the boat dock and up into the woods, that the head of that Sasquatch was above that sign. You say that's hard to believe. Well, guess what? There's people here in Oklahoma that seen him. We took an investigation from a guy this last year that saw one. That there was a sign that was 12 feet tall, and he said its head was even with the sign. 12 feet tall is hard to believe, but it scared him so bad. He grew up there. He was a rancher. He left the area. He don't want to go back down in there. So Lance and I went and checked it out with all the other brothers. So we're going to talk to this young man today and see what he saw. So his name is Braden Jones. Braden?
Nice to meet you.
All right, glad to meet you, buddy. You're pretty brave to come on the show. So what we're going to do is we're going to go sit down, and we're going to talk to the cameraman, Michael, and we're going to let you tell the folks what you seen.
Okay.
All right, good deal. Let's go.
Thank you. We came here at around 10 o'clock p.m., and so we're catfishing, and so we're going to pack up before 1 o'clock, and so we were about to leave at 12:40, and so my dad was packing up the chairs and stuff, and so I was just looking off in the distance. There's this light post that has a white sign, and it is around 9 feet. Okay, so there's right when I saw it, I saw this little this figure, and it just jumped up, and then it started running, and I could only see it for around 3 seconds. It was like running, and its arms were moving like really big, and I said, "Hey, Dad," and he said, "What?" And then already it went in the woods, and I was like, "There's this big figure in the in the up where that light post is," and he said, let me see, and then we were over here for like 5 minutes before he says, he's like, we'll come back here another time and we'll see what happened, if we can see any footprints. So then we left to go back home.
Okay, when you, I think you told me, did you have like a head lantern on when you seen it? Did you see any eye shine or anything?
No, its head was kind of diagonal, so it kind of couldn't see me. Well, it didn't want to look at me. And I did have a headlight on my...
Okay.
Yeah.
Your dad had one too?
Yes.
Okay, so both of you were, basically you'd already come off of the dock and you were loading up to go to the house, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, when you first seen him, what did you do? I mean, did you have a sudden fear, or did you just... totally excited, or were you just startled?
I didn't have time to be scared or any impression, because I could only see it for like around like 3 seconds.
Yeah, that's the way it happens for some people. They just have the glimpse of it, and then like it when it crosses the road. There's been a lot of sightings up in this part of the country, and a lot of people won't say anything about it. They're really silent about it. But I think, you know, we've done quite a few investigations and talked to quite a few people across the country. I think you're about probably the youngest person that has come on camera with an actual encounter. So this is a very big deal for us and a very big deal for you. And the viewers out there will probably be very interested in this. I mean, did you have any interest in Bigfoot or Sasquatch before you ever saw this one?
I had been watching some Bigfoot TV shows and stuff.
So you knew when you seen it, you knew what it was?
Kind of, yeah.
Okay, so there are different colored ones around. You know, we see different colored ones in the woods. People describe all kinds of them. But a solid black one, the one that, I think the one at Tim Hayhurst, he works with us, he did an encounter with us over there at the shop, and I think he lives not far from you guys. He saw one back in the 70s here when him and his dad was deer hunting over here before the lake was here. And he said it came to their campsite, and it was kind of a red one, I think. But he said it came in close to about 30, 40 feet from the campsite, and they could tell it was a Bigfoot. Of course, then Bigfoot wasn't very famous. That was right around the time Roger Patterson, introduced his film, Patterson-Gimlin film, the one they call Patty.
Yeah.
So, you know, so Patty was black colored and had been about 8 feet tall. So that's kind of what you saw about the same figure?
Yeah, but it was taller than 8 feet.
So it was taller. So we're going to say maybe it was a male one then, right?
Yeah.
Would have been a male, okay. So did he act like he was afraid or of you, or was he just wanting to get to the woods? He didn't want to be seen, or what do you think it was?
I'm pretty sure he didn't want to be seen.
Okay, well, he didn't quite make it because you saw him. But that's good. That's really good eyes that you were paying attention and caught him in the light, because, I mean, it was just, we'll look at that dumpster and everything, but from where Mike and I could tell, he was just a few seconds and he was in the woods.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they can jump a long ways, you know. So there's a lot of people that won't talk about this, and you're really brave coming on camera and telling us your encounter. Yeah. How about your schoolmates and stuff, the people you see at school? Have you said anything to your buddies or talked to them about it?
No.
Okay, you think they'll give you a hard time after they see the film?
Maybe, I don't know. Some people don't even watch this.
Well, I know. It'll get around. I mean, a lot of people will, but for the people out there at home that don't believe in these, I mean, you really have to think about it. For this young guy to come on camera and tell what he saw, we had a really, really hard time talking his mother into letting him do this because she was afraid of different things that might happen. She didn't want to have people giving him a hard time. And, you know, little kids, what they do is they just tell what they saw. They don't really know to make up anything. I mean, they can see things on TV, but when they see something, they see it. So that's why we come down here, because it's a pretty credible sighting, and being in the area where they have been seen really close to here. So, you know, this is not something I think he made up out of his head. It was actually here. So this is a pretty good size animal that he saw, and it took only 3 or 4 seconds for it to be in the woods, so it made quite a jump from that dumpster. So did it make any noise, or when it run off, did you hear any brush, or did it make any grunting sounds? Or
no, surprisingly, it made no sound when it ran.
So he's really silent, huh?
Yes.
He's just pretty swift, and he's out of there. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's what happens a lot of times. I mean, they're really silent anyway. So being you live close to the lake, and you and your dad fish here all the time, are you afraid to come back at night?
No.
So you don't think he was gonna want, he wasn't wanting to sneak up on you and hurt you or anything. He was just probably looking. He's probably trying to watch you. I bet he was watching you guys where you were fishing. More than likely, he thought maybe you left some fish behind or something. He was gonna get a free meal. But your dad, how many did you catch? You and your dad caught one or two?
Yeah, one or two.
Okay. Well, you didn't leave any for him. He's gonna take those home. So, but that's what they do. They come around, sneak around in campsites and stuff. And I mean, there's people here at the lake that probably been observed by him that didn't even know they was being watched.
Yeah.
But they are in the woods. People in Oklahoma, a lot of them don't believe it. And you know, I really wasn't into this ball game at all until I saw what I saw. And then when you see it, and you just, you know, you're not ready for it. Just let me say that, you're not ready for it. The encounters just happen. I mean, it's there in front of you, and then you don't know what to do. I mean, it's just kind of, you know, you can't, is this real? You know, and you have to think about it. But it'd be kind of hard to find a 9 foot tall guy that's walking around at 1 o'clock in the morning with a big suit on.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, what'd your dad say? What did he think about it? Y'all discuss it when you were riding home? What did he think about that?
Yeah, we were discussing it in the car.
What'd your mother say?
She wasn't really into it. She was like...
She wasn't really into it, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, some people aren't, some people aren't. But, I mean, if you ever see one, it's like, you know, it never leaves your mind. You'll never forget that as long as you live. So, did you, I mean, you'll have nightmares or anything about it?
No.
So, do you think about it quite a bit?
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, it'll. I mean, it's going to stay with you. You're really fortunate to be able to see one, because there is people that are dying to see one. There's people that want to pay to see one, and they still can't get an encounter, and they decide when this is going to happen. We don't decide. They do, because they, you know, they're interested in what you're doing, or they're sneaking around watching you fish, or watching you, you know, at your campsite or whatever.
Yeah.
And most of the time, it's you know, encounters where people don't get too scared, but there are encounters where, you know, that's kind of dangerous for people in the woods when hunters have something like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, this one here, he seemed to be like he was just maybe wanting to investigate your fishing, or he was going to look in that dumpster to see if he could find him something to eat out of there, because they've been known to do that.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you think about, you know, the Sasquatch in Oklahoma. I mean, you're in a state where they're really big in Oklahoma. What do you think about them being all over the state?
They don't really worry me that much.
Well, you don't. I mean, you act to me like you're not afraid of too much. I mean, you're in karate. Your dad's got you in karate, right?
Yeah, and my mom.
Yeah, so that takes a pretty strong young man to do that anyway. So,
yeah.
Have you ever been hunting with your dad?
No, not yet.
Okay, but you're not afraid to go, right?
No.
Okay, well, that's pretty good. I don't think we need to be afraid of these animals. I mean, I'm not afraid of them. I used to bow hunt and walk through the woods around here, even when I first started, going to tree stands in the dark and coming out in the dark and never had anything happen. I don't think they're really in the woods to try to harm people right now, but they're more really just curious about what's going on, because we've kind of encroached on their world a little bit.
Yeah.
By building the lake here and people living out around the lake and living in closer, encroaching on their area. So, you know, it's just natural that they're going to be interested in what we're doing.
Yeah.
So, you know, they try to stay hidden as much as possible, right?
Yeah.
Okay, was that what you would do if you were a Sasquatch?
Pretty much, yeah.
Would you? Okay. So, when you told your mother, how did she exactly think? I mean, how did she feel about it? Did she look at you and go, oh, Braden, are you thinking this up? Or what'd she say?
She wasn't really, she's like, oh, you really did? Okay.
So she was kind of receptive to it, right?
Yeah. Well,
that's good. Okay, a lot of people, you know, little kids see one, they'll say, oh, you're just seeing shadows or seeing things. But I found out a long time ago, you know, that when little kids see something, they see something. You know, when I was about, what are you, 9?
Yeah.
Okay, and when I was about 10 years old, I went deer hunting with my dad. And then a couple of years later, when I was hunting with him bow hunting, I was a little bit older than you were, I saw a mountain lion for my very first time in the woods. And he came by me, and, you know, he just didn't pay me no mind. I don't think he really seen me or smelled me. He was about 75 yards away, and he was just walking through the trees. And not many people get to see mountain lions here in Oklahoma. There's hunters that hunt all their life and never see one.
Yeah.
And then I became a predator caller, and I've seen quite a few of them. But so, what do you think about all this Bigfoot stuff across the country? I mean, what's your overall take on the whole scene?
I'm not really that scared about all of them. But like, if I come like face to face with them, I'm probably gonna be scared.
Well, the main thing is, you know, about predators. I'm sure your dad's told you not to run.
Yeah.
That's the main thing, not to run. And most of the encounters with little kids, I mean, that have run up on one, they really haven't been encountered them just, you know, doing something to the child. They usually just kind of check them out and go on. But, you know, it seems if the kid's in trouble, they'll try to bring it back to their parents or something. There's been 2 or 3 encounters like that. So we really don't know what to think about them being around kids, but the parents really don't want them around little kids by themselves. So, because we don't know the real intent, because we don't know that much about them. But we're trying to learn everything we can about them. And everybody says, well, they're an expert. But what do you think about somebody saying they're an expert on Sasquatch?
I'd say they're right.
You think I'm right?
Yeah.
I don't know if you can say that or not, because there hasn't been enough people. There might be people that know they're after an array of encounters, but I'm saying, like, that know everything about them. It would be hard. We'd not be hard-pressed to know everything unless you lived with one, huh?
Yeah.
So it would be a deal where you'd have to stay with them all the time and see what they do.
Yeah.
So some of the things we know that they do is kind of a guesswork. So, you know, if you, can you draw or anything? Do you ever try to think about drawing it out, what you saw, and showing your dad what it really looked like?
No.
Huh, okay. Well, there's a big perception in Oklahoma. All these Sasquatch sightings are all over the state. And there hasn't been a lot of stuff up here in Osage County, so you're about one of the first people that I've talked to that has actually seen one around the lake, except for Tim Hayhurst. Now, last deer season, when I was coming home on Highway 20, it was raining that night, and I was coming from Drummond Ranch up there, and I saw one cross the road. And I just happened to be there at the right time. It jumped the road. There was a bag of trash in the road. And it grabbed that bag of trash and was across the highway before, like your encounter, just a few seconds.
Yeah.
But I knew what it was, and there was other people coming towards me in the westbound lane. One of the guys swerved at my truck, and I had to go off the road to miss him. And I went down the road a little bit, and I stopped and got out. And the other people, kind of their brake lights come on, but they just went on. Nothing happened. So I came back the next day and took pictures of where he jumped the fence and dropped trash, so I trailed him into the woods. But he was in an awful hurry getting across that highway.
Yeah.
So I don't know if one maybe crossed before him and dropped it or what the deal was, but it's just one of them happened chance encounters, and I was right there and at the right time.
Yeah.
So that is about 4 miles, 5 miles here, straight across the lake as the crow flies. So in a straight line where you are, Tim Hayhurst seen his about 3 miles right over here.
Huh.
So, there we go. We got 3 different sightings within a 5-mile area.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Brandon, I'm gonna have you talk with Mike, and he's gonna work with your dad, and we're gonna show the people kind of what you saw. Okay. So what I want you to do is just be yourself and show the folks at home kind of what you seen and how you seen it. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, buddy, for talking to you.
Yep.
All right. All right, Braden, we're here on the dock, and we're kind of in the line of sight where you guys were fishing. Once you go over to that bush there and show us, and kind of recreating the best way you know how, just kind of show us where you see him and how he kind of walked off, okay?
Okay.
All righty.
So it was right behind this bush, kind of. It was right behind it, and it was watching us, and then... It when I saw it, I looked at it for a minute, it went right through just like 1 leap, and then it started running all the way to...
So he ran past the dumpster?
He ran past the dumpster into the trees.
Behind the dumpster.
Well, he ran behind it, and then he went in trees.
Between the sign and that dumpster.
Yeah.
So he was getting it pretty good, wasn't he?
Yes.
That's moving on for something that big, 9 foot tall, getting out of there. He was getting out of Dodge, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But at least you got to see him. That's good eyes paying attention like that.
Yeah.
Oh, nothing will be able to sneak up on you in the woods when you're hunting.
I know.
That's pretty good eyes looking around. You seem like you got a really good, your dad's got you a good headlamp there too.
Yeah.
So, can you reach up there on the sign and kind of show us how tall you think he really was? Tell me about, just tell the folks at home about how high you think he was where the writing on that sign is.
It was around 1.5 feet above that white sign, and that white sign...
So he was taller than the sign?
Yes.
Good night. That's a big one.
Yeah, and that sign is 9 feet tall.
That is a big one. I guarantee you, that's King Kong right there, my boy.
Yeah.
I'm 6 feet tall, and I can't even reach my flashlight to the top of the sign.
Yeah, there's one down in eastern Oklahoma down there where me and Lance went to talk to a rancher that saw one that tall one morning.
Yeah.
And it scared him so bad he didn't want nothing to do with it. He turned his truck around and went back to the house. Mm-hmm. So there are those that are that big out there. So there's people that really just don't know what we're dealing with. I mean, something that size, that is a very, very large animal.
Yeah.
And people say these people out there say they're a type of people and... Oh, there's a certain tribe of lost people and all this.
Yeah.
You don't believe that, do you?
No.
No, they're an animal. They're an animal. I mean, I think they're a smart animal. They know how to communicate. All animals communicate with each other.
Yeah.
But we just can't figure out their language. So, something that big, that's not normal, is it?
No.
By any account. Well, that's a very good sighting. I mean, you're a very lucky young man to be able to see that. There's a lot of people that would pay... If they could see one for that long, they'd pay $5,000 just to look at a real one that close for that long.
Yeah.
We've had them call up the channel, and they've offered Lance and I all kinds of money to take them out, but we don't really do that because of insurance problems and stuff.
Yeah.
If one of them got hurt, it'd be a really bad deal, so we can't really do that. And they're not, you know... they're not really tied in with the team or anything.
Yeah.
They wouldn't know what to do if we had some kind of a problem. We'd have to take care of them and take care of keeping them safe. And in that encounter, we could get one of our own guys hurt. So right now, we just don't do that.
Yeah.
But you were lucky with your dad. I mean, I know your dad, he's a pretty good guy, pretty smart guy. He's not going to let nothing happen to you.
Yeah.
But there's no need to fear him, I think. I don't think he's trying to hurt anybody. I think he's just trying to see if he can get a free meal.
Yeah.
Keep talking? Okay. So when he ran from the brush, just tell me, how long did it take him to get from there to the pole? 2 or 3 seconds?
two or three, yeah.
Yeah, man, he was moving. That's, it's probably, it's 20 yards from here to those rocks where you went in down there in yeah. the edge of the tree. So he made a 20-yard jump in 2 or 3 seconds. That's moving.
Yeah.
Of course, he does have a stride of about 7 feet to do that.
Yeah.
Was it dry ground or was it wet ground that night? It hadn't been raining or anything, so he didn't leave any tracks, huh?
No.
It was dry. We went and looked for any in there. It was just rocky and dry down there.
Yeah. Did you go into the woods right after that?
No.
You didn't? But you went down to the edge of the water to see if you could see anything.
Yeah.
That's probably where he come up, was along the edge of the grass there. I'm sure he was watching you guys.
Yeah.
He's probably come down here with fishermen before. They might have cleaned their fish there or whatever. I'm sure he was looking for some snacks.
Yeah, because as you can see, there's all kinds of trash in this dumpster. There's bags of cattle feed.
Yeah.
There's probably all kinds of stuff in there that they come. They probably
that night I saw the one on Highway 20. That's what he was carrying, was a bag of trash.
Yeah.
So he'd probably been to a ranch house and stole it somewhere. Somebody did, because they dropped it in the middle of the road, and he hightailed it, man. He didn't even miss a step. He grabbed that thing, was over the top of that bank before you could blink an eye.
Yeah. That night, this light, there were no lights on out here. Both of these lights were out. So the only light we had was what was on his
head.
Yeah,
so you just caught him in your headlamp, didn't you? That's
yeah.
pretty good, though. I mean, being able to see him with that headlamp, you stayed right on him, so.
That's what I was saying is earlier, is he wasn't able to see it go very far into the brush because that's all he had was his headlamp.
Yeah.
Well, you're very fortunate to be able to see him. I don't know anybody that young around here, really, that's had an encounter.
Yep.
Except for you. So you're, what, 9 years old, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, this will be something you'll never forget. You'll be able to tell your kids and your grandkids about it.
Yep.
The day you saw a Sasquatch with your dad.
Mm-hmm. Then it rained right into this area of trees, and then it zigzagged around the trees, and then it disappeared.
Where's the last place you saw it?
The last place I saw it.
Right about here?
It's right about right here. It's like right here.